Hello again, Frederick here from What's What Studios. In this episode, we are going to talk about the differences between AC and DC. Of course, this is a continuous topic with alternating details. Don't get it? Ah, you will soon. But before we jump into the different currents, we've got a special surprise for our intro. It turns out that some of our electricians at Nexans are fans of a different kind of AC/DC. No, not electric currents, you silly science geeks. The rock band from Berchet and Nexans' Denizli team in Turkey. Enjoy this rocking video. Are you ready?
Are you ready?
Who says scientists can jam? Sorry, it's been a long time. I'm just the host anyway. We got more guests coming. I will stick to the basics. Let's go back to AC/DC currents for now. DC stands for direct current and provides a constant flow of electricity in a single direction, like so. Directly to the point, as you can see. It sends energy straight to your devices. DC is measured in amps and volts, and the work performed by the current produces almighty power. The most common generation of the DC current is this. But direct current is also used in solar panels and other low voltage applications in the automotive and aviation industries. Another DC use? The electric guitar. To demonstrate, we'll share a riff from Umberto of Nexans' team in Italy. Isn't it something? Nothing quite like the direct current from an electric guitar. But way before the band AC/DC, AC currents and electric guitars, direct current was the first and arguably the most basic way to transport electricity. At the turn of the 20th century, the huge producer and lobbyer of the DC current was Thomas Edison, who used it to bring electricity to quarters of New York City. But upon expanding his reach, Edison was confronted with some drawbacks. Direct current required lots of energy to be sent long distances. And the farther it traveled, the more power it lost. The use of transformers with AC made it possible for high voltage transmission over longer distances. Then, along came the competition. Unlike the DC, the AC is an electrical current with varying magnitude and direction, hence the name alternating current. It became widely famous in the US after being manipulated by the hands of Nikola Tesla, who was intrigued by its rapid expansion in Europe. What was so amazing about AC? The current could be constantly shot back and forth, allowing for full circulation of energy. As you can see, this process creates the shape of waves, and different waveforms are used, depending on the energy needs of a given application. Alternating current usually comes from a power plant. Today, it is mainly used to power business and residential areas. But that wasn't always the case. Just over 100 years ago, there was a current war between AC and DC supporters over how to power homes. Things got a little nasty. Oh, the progressive era. We dig further into this dispute in another episode. But let's just say, at the time, AC prevailed, proving to be cheaper and easier in its usage. AC power switches were less expensive. It also had more flexibility in regards to grid management. Technicians could increase or decrease the current fairly easily depending on supply and demand. The downside, it was a bit more unpredictable and dangerous to work with. And although the generation was cheaper and the current held less losses, its transmission lines were more expensive. Direct current and alternating current are not produced in the same way. DC is produced by electrochemical or electronic generators, for example by all kinds of batteries, cells or solar panels. AC is produced by a little motor or in a power plant using an alternator. This alternator is equipped with a rotor that turns on itself and gives the electrons a sinusoidal movement. The rotor speed determines the frequency of the current. Wind, water, and vapor are a very convenient way to generate AC. But as history progressed, scientists determined the currents both have their benefits and drawbacks. Where AC was preferable for powering the grid, DC has its fair share of practical uses too. In conclusion, they are both useful and essential in their own way. And for the outro, we'd like to send away with some shockwaves from Mick and Virgo Jerry's of our Nexans team in the UK. High voltage! And we use them more than you think in everyday life. But remember, direct currents channel electricity in a straight, unidirectional line. Alternating currents have a continuous flow and push electricity in waveforms. Both are essential in everyday life, with particular uses and benefits. AC is very easy to generate with a rotor moved by a fluid or a motor. And it's okay to listen AC/DC when you're studying AC/DC. Last but not least, we'd like to thank our teams who contributed to the rocking covers for this installment of What's What. When you ask me why I like to dance. And what about you, viewers out there? Who's your favorite guitar player to ever explore the science of sound? Angus, Hendrix, Clapton? Let us know in the comments below. Maybe you'll one day discover a new radio wave of your own. See you later, scientists. Rock on!